The UK has unveiled a major advancement in its next-generation fighter program, the Tempest. With the initiation of flight trials for the Flight Test Aircraft FTA, known as Excalibur. Based on a Boeing 757 airliner, Excalibur flies as a testing platform for innovative technologies essential to future combat aircraft. On December 9th, a milestone was reached when Leonardo, 2XL, and the UK Ministry of Defence confirmed that the Excalibur Flight Test Aircraft FTA had successfully completed its first round of modifications and flight assessments. In this crucial stage, the aircraft underwent upgrades that included the installation of new side and belly-mounted pods designed to improve flight stability. Following this, the aircraft will now enter a new phase of refinement at Shinnatic's Boscombe Down facility in Wiltshire, where further engineering work will take place. These modifications are intended to host sophisticated systems such as the integrated sensors, non-kinetic effects, ISANKI, and integrated communication systems, ICS, all crucial components of the UK-led Global Combat Air Programme, GCAP. This collaborative effort also involves Italy and Japan, with Tempest being central to the UK's Future Combat Air System FCAS agenda. Excalibur is currently seen operating from Boscombe Down in Wiltshire, southern England. While the aircraft is fitted with critical fairings, the cutting-edge demonstration systems are yet to be installed. These systems are anticipated to be aboard by the next years as testing and refinement proceed. The advanced radar developed under Leonardo's multifunction radio frequency system is expected to be key in the finalized aircraft design. Excalibur's future involves further significant engineering enhancements to ensure robust testing for the eventual deployment of the Tempest fighter by 2035. Artists' renderings of the final FTA configuration also show additional fairings under the nose, perhaps for an electro-optical sensor, and on the side of the nose. Two further fairings are also shown below the rear fuselage. In the past, 2XL has stated that Excalibur is planned to have a maximum payload capacity of 16 tons and will operate at an altitude of 42,000 feet at speeds as high as Mach 0.86. The aircraft has a maximum range of 3,900 nautical miles and an endurance of 8 hours. Excalibur, once a commercial Boeing 757, has been repurposed as an experimental platform for testing cutting-edge technologies that will eventually be integrated into the UK's Future Combat Air System, FCAS. In the United States, Honeywell has long used a 757 for test duties, while Boeing's 757 flying test bed, better known as the catfish due to its unique and highly modified nose profile, is used in support of the F-22's sensor and electronic warfare suite. It features a Raptor nose grafted onto the forward fuselage, containing the ANAPG-77 active electronically scanned array AESEA radar. A swept wing section atop the flight deck houses conformal antennas for the Raptor's AN/ALR-94 electronic support measures suite. The catfish also seems to have influenced at least one similar platform operated by China. Here, a specially adapted Russian-made Tupolev Tu-204C, itself essentially a clone of the 757, is used for avionics testing for the J-20 stealth fighter. This ambitious program is not limited to just the development of a new fighter jet, but also aims to encompass a wide array of capabilities, including unmanned aerial systems, advanced data and communication systems, and next-generation weaponry. These high-tech components, being developed by Leonardo UK in partnership with international collaborators, will provide invaluable data and feedback to shape the fighter's systems and capabilities. As the program progresses, the Excalibur will continue to serve as a crucial testbed for the future of combat aviation. The Global Combat Air Program, GCAP, represents one of the most ambitious and significant international collaborations in the history of modern air combat technology. Initiated by the United Kingdom, Italy, and Japan, the program is designed to create a next-generation fighter jet that will not only redefine the future of air combat, but also serve as a platform for cutting-edge systems and technologies. As the global military landscape evolves, GCAP aims to ensure that its partners are at the forefront of aerial warfare, with a fighter that can integrate seamlessly into future combat scenarios and stay ahead of emerging threats. The roots of the GCAP initiative trace back to the early 2020s when the three nations recognized the need for a shared next-gen air combat capability that could counter advanced adversaries and operate in increasingly complex multi-domain environments. The UK, Italy, and Japan each bring unique capabilities to the table with a shared vision of developing a versatile and highly capable fighter aircraft alongside a broader combat air system. The three countries' decision to join forces was, in part, driven by the growing costs and complexities of developing cutting-edge military technologies independently, as well as the realization that only through collaboration could they achieve their ambitious goals within the desired timelines. At the heart of the GCAP program is the Next Generation Fighter, which will integrate advanced sensor systems, enhanced communication networks, and a variety of cutting-edge weapons. The goal is to create a flexible, adaptable platform that can engage in air superiority, strike missions, and multi-role operations across multiple domains, from air to ground to sea. Unlike traditional fighter jets, the GCAP aircraft will also serve as the centerpiece of an integrated combat system, offering the ability to communicate with other manned and unmanned assets in real time, sharing critical information for a collaborative approach to warfare. The UK, under its Ministry of Defence, MOD, and aerospace giants like BAE Systems, is tasked with leading the program's development and integration efforts. The UK's role will focus heavily on the design and production of the fighter's airframe, advanced avionics, and mission systems. In addition to this, BAE Systems will be instrumental in developing the aircraft's flight control systems, human-machine interface, and other core technologies that ensure the fighter can operate in high-threat environments with maximum effectiveness. Italy's involvement, led by Leonardo and supported by other key players such as MBDA, brings considerable expertise in the development of sensor systems, avionics, and weapons systems. Leonardo, one of Europe's largest aerospace and defense companies, will contribute to the development of the fighter's electronic warfare, EW systems, advanced radar systems, and cockpit interfaces. Italy's strengths in missile technology, particularly in the areas of air-to-air and air-to-ground weapons, will also play a significant role in shaping the GCAP fighter's armament. This partnership will ensure that the fighter can carry out both defensive and offensive operations with precision and versatility, using the latest guided weapons and munitions. Japan's contribution to the program is primarily focused on advanced technologies in stealth, propulsion, and systems integration. The Japanese aerospace company Mitsubishi Heavy Industries, MHI, will be working on the development of the fighter's propulsion systems, which will incorporate next-gen engines capable of providing superior performance, efficiency, and stealth characteristics. Japan is also contributing to the development of high-performance radar and sensor fusion systems, which will enable the aircraft to process and interpret vast amounts of data from its surroundings in real time. With Japan's experience in designing and producing advanced military aircraft like the F-2 and the Mitsubishi ATDX, the country is bringing invaluable expertise to the GCAP project. The planned fighter will not be just an evolution of current aircraft, but will introduce several revolutionary features. The aircraft's design will be stealthy, not only in terms of radar cross-section, but also in terms of infrared signature, making it highly survivable against advanced enemy sensors. These UAVs will work in tandem with the fighter, extending its operational range and capability by conducting surveillance, providing electronic warfare support, and even engaging enemy targets, Another key component of the broader GCAP initiative is the development of advanced communication networks, allowing the fighter to operate in a fully integrated, multi-domain combat environment. These networks will connect the fighter with other assets, such as ground-based air defense systems, naval vessels, and unmanned systems, enabling a seamless flow of information and real-time decision-making. The GCAP program is also addressing the future of autonomous warfare. The fighter aircraft will be designed with the capability to operate alongside unmanned platforms, either under the control of human pilots or autonomously. This will allow for increased operational flexibility, as well as a reduction in the risk to human life in high-risk missions. The integration of AI and machine learning into the aircraft's systems will enable it to make real-time decisions, enhance situational awareness, and increase the effectiveness of its weapons systems. Looking ahead, the GCAP project promises to be a game-changer in the field of combat aviation. As the first prototypes begin to take shape and flight tests progress, the world will watch closely to see how this unprecedented international collaboration will deliver a truly next-generation fighter aircraft. If you enjoy content like this, please go ahead and like and subscribe to this video because I appreciate all your support.